Krieg! What are you doing back there?
I was tasting the soup.
Well, stay away from that soup. Do something to help me. Hang these clean clothes on the line. And keep that fire going.
Another cup, have you?
What for?
The tent's on fire.
Oh! Oh! Earthly possessions are slowly getting less and less. No place to sleep and no food. What could be worse? Come on.
Where we're going?
Do I have to tell you everything?
Not everything.
Well, if you must know, we are going to humiliate ourselves by begging for food.
What, again?
Crank the car.
Oh, I feel so silly I'll never be able to act again. I can't.
Oh, you're wonderful.
You are wonderful.
Yes, I know, but I never could do it before an audience.
Oh, yes, come on.
Play it the way you did just now, and you'll be the hit of the community play this year. Now, the scene opens in the country. The old lady is seated in the chair, and in comes the villain with the mortgage.
How about trying here for some food?
That's not a bad idea. I'll see if there's any dogs. It's okay. There's no dogs. Come on.
Thank you.
pardon the intrusion, lady, but my friend and I are victims of the depression. We haven't tasted food for 3 whole days.
Fancy not eating for 3 whole days.
Yes, ma'am. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
We were wondering if you would be kind enough to provide us with a piece of buttered toast.
Oh, why, certainly.
Would you mind throwing a piece of ham over that?
Oh, don't you worry. I'll fix you something very nice.
1,000 thanks. Is there some little thing we could do to repay you for your kindness? We're willing to work, you know.
Oh, no, I think not.
How about you chopping some wood?
That would be splendid.
Splendid it shall be.
That's fine. I'll call you when it's ready.
Why did you have to suggest cutting wood?
I didn't suggest it. You said to
oh,
the lady...
Oh, shut up. You make me sick. Well, you suggested it. Now you cut it.
Well, I don't know anything about cutting wood.
Well, you ought to. You once told me your father was in the lumber business.
Well, I know he was, but it was only in a small way.
What do you mean, small way?
Well, he used to sell toothpicks.
Well, go ahead and make some toothpicks. Be a chip off of the old block.
Already, boys. Come right along. There you are, boys. Now make yourselves right at home.
Gee, this is certainly nice of you.
Oh, don't mention it. It's all right. Have a good time.
Thank you.
Your service.
What do you want?
Tut, tut, don't let us bandy words. I am here to foreclose the mortgage in your home and turn you into the street.
So, James Finlayson, you thought to catch me unprepared and at your mercy. But this time, you are foiled. I am ready for this emergency. I am going to pay you. Then you can go. Go. And never darken my door
again.
At last, Christine de Manville, I have you in my clutches.
Spare me. It's only $100. Give me just a little more time.
Not one more minute. And if you're not out of this house by 3 o'clock, I'll have my minions throw you out, bag and baggage.
My hour has come. What will I do?
We've got to do something to help that old lady.
I wish we could.
One good turn deserves another.
So do I neither.
What do you mean, so do I neither? Why, don't you realize they're going to throw her into the streets?
What can we do?
We've got to raise $100.
$100?
Yes.
We couldn't even raise $1,000. We haven't got a dime. What are we going to do?
I had it.
What?
An idea to raise the money.
Let's go tell
her. No. We'll sneak out and not tell anyone. We'll surprise her. Now, don't you tell anyone where we're going to get the money. Here is to raise $100 to save a poor gray-haired old lady from being thrown into the streets. My friend and I are willing to sacrifice our all by offering this car to the highest bidder.
Just what are you two fellas trying to do?
We're trying to sell this car to raise $100 to keep a poor old lady from being thrown into the streets.
Anybody will help a poor old lady. I'll give her $100.
That's the spirit, folks! I bid $100!
Have you got the time?
$100! Once! $100! Twice!
Huh?
The third and last call!
$125.
Sold for $125! And I thank you for your kind attention! Who said $125?
I did. I was telling him the time.
Oh. What's that? Where'd you get it? Now I see it all.
What?
What? Don't try to alibi. You know you stole this money from the old lady. Why, guilt is written all over you.
What do you mean, guilt?
I mean that you're going to give this money back and make a full confession.
A confession of what?
I think for all these years I've been fostering a common thief. A viper in my bosom.
Who's bosom? What are you talking
don't
about?
Don't try to bluff me. To think you would bite the hand that was feeding you.
I didn't mean...
You snake in the grass. You traitor. You sheep in wolf's clothing. You double-crosser. You Judas. You.
Stop. Don't call me a you.
Miss me, didn't you? Oh, you don't. Get in that car. You'll go back and tell the truth. The whole truth and nothing but...
Yes, he's the one who stole your money and left you at the mercy of that villain.
Why, there must be some mistake.
There's no mistake. It's all too true. Why, I caught him red-handed.
There hasn't been any money stolen. We were just rehearsing a play for the community player.
I must have made a faux pas. No! Go! No!
Come on.
Wait, 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 no! Wait, no!
Just like that!